This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah, come to the big data. We have the two keywords. One is the big data, one is the Hadoop, right? If you can search in the Naukri and the any job portal, you can find the two profiles. One is the big data profile, one is the Hadoop profile. Anyone knows these two keywords? Yes, big data in Hadoop. What is that?
Big data might be a kind of environment where you will deal with large amount of data, and Hadoop is a framework which usually deals with big data.
Yes, excellent, good. Yeah, big data is the one of the problem actually. Big data is a problem because of we are storing a huge amount of the data. We are playing the huge amount of the data. If you want to store this in the normal system, it is very difficult to store. It is very difficult to maintain the data. So this is the one of the biggest problem in the traditional file system. Big data is a problem. And come to the Hadoop. What is the Hadoop? Hadoop is the one of the solution for the big data. So what is the problem we have? Yes, this is the solution. Hadoop is the one of the solution and big data is a problem. What is the problems we have in the traditional system? What is the problems? Yeah, main problem, major problem is the first is the storage is the one of the problem. Storage is the one of the problem. And second is the processing is the one of the biggest problem. If you want to process this huge amount of the data, it is take huge time. It is take the huge time to process the data. So this is the major problems in that traditional file system. How we are going to overcoming these problems with the help of the Hadoop, with the help of the, if you want to store the huge amount of the data, yes, one of the best solution. This is not the only one solution. This is the best solution for the big data. One of the solution is the storage is the one of the solution. So if you want to store the huge amount of the data, yes, it is possible to store in the Hadoop environment. And also if you want to process the huge amount of the data, so if we can able to process the huge amount of the data with Hadoop only, how we are going to process, how we are going to store, so going forward we will discuss. Okay, so this is the Hadoop is the one of the solution for this problem, storage and the processing. And if you can categorize total big data into three parts, we can categorize the total big data into three parts. One is NoSQL. Yes, go ahead. Any questions? Okay, no problem. NoSQL is the one of the category, and next is the Hadoop is the one of the category, and the third one is the Hadoop ecosystems. Hadoop ecosystem. What is the NoSQL? Total big data we can categorize into three parts. One is the NoSQL, Hadoop, and Hadoop ecosystem. What is the NoSQL? NoSQL is not only structured query language. Same as the RDBMS. What is the RDBMS? Relational database management system, right? So if you can take the Oracle, DB2, Netezza, MySQL, SQL Server, these are all the RDBMS. Same if you want to use the transactional purpose. What is that? That is a transactional purpose, right? So if you want to use any transactional purpose from Hadoop side, we are going to use the any one of the NoSQL concept. Not only structured query language, it is same as the database, nothing but the database. So we have the, so total NoSQL, we have the four ecosystems is there. Four systems, what is that? One is the HBase. HBase is a one of the NoSQL concept, and Cassandra is a one of the NoSQL concept. And next is MongoDB is one of the NoSQL concept, and finally is Bigtables. Bigtables is a one of the NoSQL concept. We have the four NoSQL concepts is there based on your requirement, based on your project requirement. We are going to use any one of the NoSQL concept, but we have the total, we have the four NoSQL concepts is there: HBase, Cassandra, MongoDB, and Bigtables. Based on our requirement, we are going to use any one of the NoSQL concept. Okay, so here is the HBase. HBase is the same as a RDBMS, only here is we are going to store the, based on that row ID, we are going to store the data. And come to the Cassandra. You can take the Cassandra, you can take the Facebook. Facebook is depends on the Cassandra only. The total Facebook is developed with the Cassandra ecosystem only, Cassandra NoSQL only. Okay, and you can take the all the mobile applications. We are using the all the Apple and the all the Android mobile applications, right? So the total mobile application is developed with the MongoDB only. Is the backend is the MongoDB is running. So based on our requirement, based on our project requirement, we are going to use any one of the NoSQL concept. We are not going to use all the NoSQLs. We have the same. We have the RDBMS set. Oracle DB2 Netezza is there. So based on our requirement, we are going to choose any one of the RDBMS tool, and we are going to develop the project. Same here also, we have the various NoSQL concepts is there. Based on our requirement, we are going to choose any one of the NoSQL database, and we are going to develop the projects. Okay.
I just have a question. So is big data only capable of connecting to only these kind of databases, or can we use any key value, document?
We have the, we have the, nowadays we have 30 to 40 ecosystems.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to explain in the Hadoop ecosystems.
Okay.
But we should not learn the all the things. We should learn the some of the concepts, and we need to explore on the remaining ecosystems. If you want to learn the all the 30 to 40 concepts, it will take the around 2 to 3 years of the time.
Can we connect any kind of NoSQL database to big data environment? I mean, can we use
Yes, we can.
Yeah, okay.
And come to the Hadoops. These are all the four NoSQL concepts. And come to the Hadoop is categorized into three parts. What is that? One is the HDFS. And next is the MapReduce. And next is Yarn. Total Hadoop, we can categorize it into three parts. One is the HDFS, MapReduce, and Yarn. What is the HDFS? HDFS is a Hadoop distributed file system. Hadoop distributed file system. So here is the, we have the traditional file system. What is the traditional file system? Our normal file system, all the Windows system, we can call it as a traditional file system. We are going to store as a some folder structure, right? So come to the Hadoop side. If you want to store any data, we are going to use the HDFS file system. This is the Hadoop distributed file system. This is not the normal file system. This is the distributed file system. You are going to use any of the ecosystems, not only now NoSQL concept. We have the Hive, Impala, and remaining ecosystems is there. So if you want to store any data, backend is the HDFS only. Backend is a HDFS. We can call it the HDFS is the heart of the Hadoop. Without HDFS, we cannot store any data. We cannot able to store any data. So we are going to store all the data in HDFS only. On top of the HDFS, we are going to store all the data. How we are going to store? This is a distributed file system. How we are going to store in HDFS? How we are going to distributing all the data across the cluster? So we will, going forward, we will discuss. But HDFS is the file system. This is a distributed file system. Okay. And come to the, so this is the one of the problem, right? What is the problem? We have storage, right? So we are going to overcoming this problem with the HDFS only. We can able to store the huge amount of the data. If you want to store the petabytes of the data, so we can able to store on top of the HDFS. So we are overcoming one of the problem, storage problem with the HDFS only. And come to the MapReduce. MapReduce is for to processing the data. To processing the huge amount of the data. Yes, we have the one of the problem. What is the problem? Processing, right? So we are overcoming this problem, processing problem with the MapReduce only. But if you want to write the MapReduce program, it is a purely depends on the Java program only. If you can strong on the Java, then only you can able to write the MapReduce program. So we need to create the classes, we need to create the functions, we need to create the jars, we need to run the jars, then only we are going to process the huge amount of the data. But if you want to write any code in the MapReduce, you should have strong knowledge on the Java only. But how we are going to use this? But I don't know the Java. How we are going to write the code to process the data? Yes. But nowadays, no one is using the MapReduce program. Only some companies. Some companies still using the MapReduce. Already we know Java is a very difficult. Yes or no? If you want to write any code in the Java, that is very difficult. Already we know this. So if you want to write the MapReduce program in the Java, that is also very difficult to write the code. So that's why these all the ecosystems has introduced in the previous. Before this, we have the MapReduce program only. In the 2000 means here is we are going to store this. That's it. Here is we are going to store the data in HBase, Cassandra, MongoDB, big tables. But if you want to process the data, we are going to use the MapReduce program only. But nowadays, what is the ecosystem? Latest ecosystem, the 2014 and 15, Spark has introduced it. Instead of this, we are going to use the all the ecosystem. We have the apart from the MapReduce program, we have the Hive is there, Impala is there, Scoop is there. So we have some of the ecosystems is there. So we are going to use that ecosystem to process the data. But backend is running the MapReduce program only. Instead of the Java programming, we can use the other ecosystems. What is the ecosystems we have? We have the Hive is there, Impala is there. All are the ecosystems. We have the around 30 to 40 ecosystems is there. Okay, Scope, Pig, Uzi, Spark Streaming, Kafka Streaming, Flume, Flunk. So many ecosystems is there. Still they are introducing the Apache is introducing the so many ecosystems. Yes, we are using the one ecosystem, one tool. So we have some drawbacks is there. To overcoming that, they are going to introduce the one more ecosystem. So they are introducing the new ecosystems in the market. The Apache has introducing the new ecosystems in the market. But before that, before MapReduce means before these ecosystems, previous we are going to process with the MapReduce program only. Once Hive and Impala, Scoop, Pig, and these are all the ecosystems I introduced. So if you can use this ecosystem, it's the same as the SQL queries only. If you can strong on the SQL queries, you can able to process the data with the help of this Hive, Impala, R, Cassandra, MongoDB, Bigtables, HBase, all our backend is running. You are running the select star from table. Just you can assume that. You can take the Hive, okay? You are writing the select star from table, but backend is converting into the MapReduce program and processing the data and finally is giving that result. Okay. If you want to write the same code in the MapReduce program, you should write the code in the Java only. We have some of the classes is there. Mapper class, reducer class, partition class, combiner class, and different classes is there, and custom classes. We need to create the custom classes to process the data. Means under that classes, you should write the, if you want to declare the variable, if you want to read the data from the source, if you want to process the data, you should write the code in the Java only. That is very difficult to write. But so to overcoming this, Apache has introduced some of the ecosystems, Hive, Impala, HBase, Cassandra, these are all the ecosystems. If you are running the code, what will happen is the backend is running the MapReduce program. But we should know the how to run the MapReduce program. Yes, you are running the select star from table. Just you can assume that. Is the backend is converting into the MapReduce program. But how it is running, how the framework is running, how the MapReduce framework is running, which component is helping to process the data, we should know. As a developer, we should know that information. Yes, in the console, what are the code you are writing, you are running. So in the console, every component is displaying and is showing all the end-to-end scenarios. We should know how it is running, how many mappers is running, how many reducers is running, if the mapper is failed, why it is failing. So we should know that information. So that's why I'm going to cover this part also. But I'm not going to cover the programming part. If I can start the programming part, you should have the knowledge of the Java only. If I can start the total MapReduce program, it will take huge time because we are not using this MapReduce program, but still we are using the framework, Hadoop framework, MapReduce framework. So that's why I'm going to cover this part. As part of our course, we are going to cover this HDFS also, obviously. Without HDFS, there is no big data, okay? Okay, this is the MapReduce to processing the data. So if you want to write the any code in the MapReduce, you should have strong knowledge on the Java only. But presently we are not using. So to overcoming this, we have the latest ecosystems, Hive, Impala, Scoop, everything is there. But latest ecosystem is the Spark. Spark is ruling the industry. Because of without Spark, there is no big data concept. You are working on one big data project means, so you should have the Spark. You should have the knowledge on the Spark only. As part of our course, I'm going to cover this part. Don't worry about this, okay? And come to the Hadoop. One of the third category is the YARN. What is the YARN? YARN is a yet another resource negotiator. So this is the latest framework. We are using the Hadoop framework, means this is a MapReduce framework. But we have some drawbacks is there. Here is Hadoop 1.x version, Hadoop 2.x version. Currently, last 5 months, 5 months back, Apache has introduced the SPA, Hadoop 3.x version as well. But all the industry is using the 2.x version, Hadoop 2.x version. Hadoop 1.x version, we have some drawbacks is there. To overcoming the drawbacks in the YARN framework. This is the one of the framework, latest framework, yet another resource negotiator. What is the drawback is there? How we are going to overcoming the drawback in the YARN, we will discuss. Going forward, we'll discuss that. Okay. Just I am trying to introducing all the ecosystem. That's it. Okay. From tomorrow onwards, we will discuss one by one. And come to the Hadoop ecosystems. Yeah, Hive, Impala, Scoop, Pig, Uzi is there. So what is the Hive? What is the use of the Hive? Hive is a, Hive is an analytical purpose. You can take any project. We have the two types of the projects. One is the transactional purpose, one is the analytical purpose. What is the use of the transactional purpose? So for suppose you are running one business, if you want to maintain the transaction, if you want to maintain the some customer details, just you can assume that customer details, how you are going to maintain. So you are going to, in the backend, you are going to use the any Oracle, DB2, NetJoin, MySQL databases, right? So here you are maintaining the transactional databases. Means you are maintaining the transaction, the daily transaction you are maintaining. Means what is the use of the transaction? Transaction is for to running the business, to running purpose. We are maintaining some transactionals. There we are using the primary key, foreign key. For suppose you have the one customer is there. For every customer, we are creating the one unique ID. Means that is nothing but the primary key. Yes or no? So here also, we have the two types of the project, right? One is the transactional purpose, one is the analytical purpose. Based on your requirement, yes, in the real time also, we are going to work on any one of the project. It may be the transactional purpose, it may be the analytical purpose. Why we are going to use the transactional purpose? To running the business. What is the use of the analytical purpose? To improving the business. For suppose they are taking the last 10 years data. They are going to analysis how I'm going to improve my business. In the 2010, the business has written as a just you can assume that $10 million. In the 2012, is that $12 million? And for suppose in the 2015, it may be the 1 million. Why my business has decreased? How I am going to improve my business? They are going to analysis on the existing data. So what is the new features I want to implement in my business? So that is the analytical purpose. For suppose we have the two types of the product. One is the transactional purpose, is a daily basis, is a to running the business purpose. We are going to use the transactional databases. Come to the analytical purpose, to improving our business, we are going to use the any one of the analytical databases. That is the Hive and Impala is the analytical purpose from the Hadoop side. For suppose you are working as the transactional databases, we are going to choose the any one of these ecosystem. For suppose you are working as an analytical purpose, we are going to choose any one of these ecosystem, Hive or Impala. It may be not to any one of the ecosystems. Here is also, we are not going to use all the four ecosystems. We are going to use any one of based on our requirement. That will take the decision from the client or the managers will take the decision. What is the best ecosystem is suitable for this project? Okay. And come to the, what is the Hive? What is the same as the SQL only. We can call it as a .hql. What is that HQL? High query language. High query language, same as the SQL. If you can strong on the SQL queries, how you are going to join the two tables, how you are going to group, how you are going to implement the aggregate methods, how you are going to union, how you are going to join, everything same as the SQL queries only. Some difference is there, some 10% of the difference is there, but if you can strong on the SQL queries, you can able to write the code in the Hive also. It is very easy. So instead of previous, we have the before Hive, we have the MapReduce is there. Same, if you want to join the two tables, for suppose in the source, I have the two tables is there. I want to join the two tables. Yes, if you can achieve that requirement with the MapReduce program. But if you want to write the MapReduce program, you should have strong knowledge on the Java only. So first you need to create the variables, you need to read the data. So you need to process that, you need to join the two tables, you need to process the data, finally you are going to store into the output screen. But come to the Hive, if you can strong on this, already you know the SQL queries, yes or no? So if you can strong on the SQL queries, then you can able to write the Hive queries also. This is, we can call it as a .hql files. In the SQL side, we can call it as an SQL, right? Structured query language. Come to the Hive side, we can call it as an HQL, high query language, okay? And come to the Impala. Impala is also same as the SQLs only. What are the query we are running in the Hive side? Same query we can able to write, we can able to run from the Impala side as well. There is no difference between the Hive and the Impala. So based on some requirements, but come to the storage options. We have the different storage options. Is that we can able to store the data as an Avro, Parquet, WASC, different formats. Same, come to the Impala side also, we can able to store in the different formats also, text file. So we will, going forward, we will discuss how we are going to store, how we are going to create the table, how we are going to get the data from the databases, how we are going to join the two tables. So when we are joining the tables, what will happen in the back end? So everything we will discuss, okay? And come to the Impala is also same as the analytical purpose. We are going to use the analytical purpose. All the NoSQL concepts is the transactional purpose. Come to the Hive and Impala is the analytical purpose. We are going to use the analytical purpose. Okay. And come to the scope. What is the use of the scope? These are all the ecosystems. Not only these ecosystems, we have the 30 to 40 ecosystems is there. I'm not going to cover that part, but major ecosystems I'm trying to explain. Okay. And scope. What is the use of the scope? Scope is to import, and for suppose you are working as a big data developer, you are working in a one cluster, okay? But my source data is available in the RDBMS. That is a different cluster. That is a different server. So how I am going to get the data from that server to my Hadoop server? How are you going to get the data? With the help of the scope only. Your source is available in the different servers. It may be the Oracle, maybe the Netija, it may be the SQL server, It may be the MySQL, any different server. I want to get the data from that server to my Hadoop environment. How you are going to get? With the help of the scope, means import and export the data from RDBMS to Hadoop environment. Import and export the data from any RDBMS to Hadoop environment. We are going to use this ecosystem, scope ecosystem. Okay, and come to the picture.
Yes, I just have a question. So does Scoopy is having all the any kind of ETL capabilities also, or it is just kind of exporting the and importing and only, exporting the data?
We are not going to. Yes, good question. This is an excellent question. We are not going to process the data. Just we are going to import and export. Import and export. This is only meant for to import and export the data from the any RDBMS to Hadoop environment. We are not going to process the data. Come to here, Hive and Impala, we can able to process the data. First, suppose we have the 10 tables is there. I want to join. I want to order by. I want to do some operations. Means internally we are processing the data. Yes or no? You are joining two tables means you are doing some processing. You are doing some operations. Yes or no? Come to this group side. We are not going to do. Only this is for meant for to import and export the data from the RDBMS to Hadoop environment. Get my point? Hello. Clear?
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Okay, fine. We will discuss. We will discuss one by one. We will discuss. Okay. And come to the pig. Yeah, pig is the Latin script actually. If you want to process the data before these, what is that? Spark. Before Spark, you can take the Spark. These also we can able to process the RAM level. Here is the two types of the processing. One is the batch processing. One is the RAM level processing. All the MapReduce is a batch processing. We are going to process in the disk level. Come to the Spark. This is a RAM level processing. We are processing in the RAM level only. Just you can assume what is the difference between that batch level and the RAM level means. Just you can assume that you are processing, you are joining two tables. Just you can assume that it is taking the 100 minutes of the time in the MapReduce, with the help of the MapReduce. It's taking the 1.5 hours. Just you can assume that. Same program you can run in the Spark, it will take the 1 minute of the time. 1 minute of the, just you can assume that. That's why industry is looking for the Spark developers. So it's giving the fast performance. It's reducing the processing time. Okay. So we will discuss how we are going to overcome. What is the difference between the Spark framework and the MapReduce framework? Why still we are using the Spark? So everything we will discuss. Come to the same. Pig is also same as that. We are going to use the Latin script. Here is, if you want to process the two tables, so we are going to use some scripting, same as we have the some, what is that, VB script and shell script, everything is there, right? So what is the use of that? Just we are going to process the data, right? Same thing, if you want to process the data, the Spark side, so we are going to use this Pig Latin script. Here we are going to use the Latin script. This is the Latin script. So currently we are not using the pig, the previous before 2015. So all the developers are used the before Spark. So they are used to process the data with the pig only. Nowadays no one is using. But if you want to process the data, we can use this. If you want to process it, we should have that. This is the Latin script. We are using the some Latin script. Okay. Here is the some cut, put, get, something is there. Some of the commands is there. With the help of the commands, we are going to process the data. Okay, presently we are not using, but if you want to use this, here is the, we are using the Latin scripting. Latin script. This is the Latin script. Okay, and come to the OSI. What is the use of the OSI? So OSI is the job scheduling tool. Here is the job scheduling tool. Already you have written one code. Just you can assume that I have written one code. I want to schedule the job. In the production environment, how you are going to schedule the job? We are automatically scheduling the job, right? Yes or no? So first of all, I have developed one code. Okay. I want to run the same job every day at 10 o'clock, every week at 10 o'clock. I want to schedule the job. How you are going to schedule? We have the so many ecosystems is there. So many ecosystems. Come to the Hadoop side, we have the OSI is the one of the ecosystem to schedule the jobs. This is the job scheduling tool. Job scheduling tool. So we have the control M is one of the scheduling tool. and you can take the crontab is one of the scheduling tool, tmc is the one of that scheduling. We have the so many scheduling tools is there. So come to the Hadoop side, we have the one of the based on their requirement. I don't know, so in the project you are working on one project, based on their requirement they are going to use the TWS or crontab, or it may be the Control-M, it may be the Woozi, anyone they can use to schedule the jobs, all the jobs. Okay, this is one of the job scheduling tool. Okay, same only thing is this is a one-time setup. So already you have written some code. So Woozi said we have the some files is there, job.properties and xml.properties, some of the xml files is there. We are going to schedule, means we are going to pass our job information in the Woozi tool. Automatically is going to trigger the job every day, at what time you want to schedule the job, at what time you want to run the job. So in the Woozi we can schedule our jobs, all the Hadoop jobs. Okay, and come to this part. Already I told you this is the latest ecosystem. It's a RAM level processing. RAM level processing means is that we are running in the, we are not going to use the disk levels, we are going to run this all the jobs in the RAM level only. So already you know, disk level is the, it is just like the batch level, means batch by batch, some batch is running, some batch is waiting. So it's in the queue level. Come to the Spark is that it's the RAM level processing. We are going to use the memories, in the memory only, in the cache memory only, we are going to process all the jobs. This is the very latest in the 2015. From the 2015 onwards, we are using this part. But in the 2014, it has introduced it. In the 2015, the POC has executed after the 2015. So all the companies, all in the projects, in all the big data projects, Spark has introduced it. But if you want to work on the Spark, you should have at least, you should know at least one programming language. Not only the Java. If you have knowledge on the Java, that is very deep. That is very, it is an advantage. So if you have the, apart from Java, if you know the Scala, if you know the Python, if you know the R, we can use any one of the language. We can use the any one of the language. If you want to write the Spark query, you can use any one of the language. It may be the Java, it may be the Scala, it may be the Python, it may be the Ruby, any one of the language you can use. And you can write the code in the Spark to process the data. Okay, and come to the Spark streaming. Already you know the Spark streaming, right? Spark streaming means this is all the static data. These are all the static data, means this is the only the is not the that is a batch level, means batch by batch we are reading the data, we are processing the data. Come to the Spark streaming means is the streaming of data access. You can take the Facebook, you can take the Twitter, how the data is changing. In the fraction of a second, the data is changing. If you want to process that type of the data also, if you want to process that type of the data, we are going to use any one of these ecosystems. Spark streaming, Kafka streaming, and the Flume. But if you want to write the Spark streaming and the Kafka streaming and the Flume streaming, so you should have strong knowledge on the Java or Scala only. Otherwise, it is not possible. Otherwise, it is not possible. I know the SQL queries. So if I want to run the Spark streaming and the Kafka, this is not possible. You should have, but come to the big data side. If you can strong on the hype, yes, you can able to work as a big data developer. But come to the, if you want to work, if you want to write the Spark streaming, Kafka streaming, and the Flume, you should have strong knowledge on the Java. Generally, you can able to write this code. If you want to work as a streaming project, so you should have the strong knowledge on the Java. Then only you can able to write the Spark streaming code, Kafka streaming code, and the Flume. So, but in the industry, in the market, we have the 5 to 10% of the profiles is on this Spark and Kafka only, Spark streaming and the Kafka only. Remaining 90% of the profiles, we have the Spark, and these are all the ecosystem. Okay, and these are all the streaming of data access. If the data is continuously flowing, continuously changing, if you can take the any Oracle, for suppose the data is not changing the continuously, yes or no, it's a weekly basis, it's a monthly basis, the data is changing. Come to the streaming means if you can take the Twitter or Facebook, you can take the any one of the streaming data, So if you want to process that type of the data, so we are going to use any one of these ecosystems: Spark Streaming, Kafka Streaming, and the Flume. Okay, these are also one of the streaming concepts. These are Flunk also. Okay, we have, apart from this, we have the some other ecosystems is there. So I'm not going to explain that part, but this is the major ecosystem what we have discussed now. So you can take, just you can talk with you who are working on the big data develop, just you can discuss with them. So you can know the what is the major ecosystem they are using currently in their project. You can heard about these ecosystems only. Major projects is on these ecosystems only. So that's why I'm explaining. But we have these all the ecosystems, right? These are as part of our course. I'm going to cover the first is the you should have the Linux as part of our course. What I'm going to cover, see here. If you want to work on a big data developer, you should have strong knowledge on the Linux only. We are not going to work as a Windows environment. In the real time also, we are going to work on Linux environment. So if you want to work on the Linux, you should have knowledge on the Linux command. So that's why I'm going to cover the Linux commands also. This is the first point. Okay. And come to the, here is we have the, you are working on the Linux command, and also if you want to read the data from the HDFS is the our file system, right? If you want to read the data from the HDFS, you should have the knowledge on the Hadoop commands. Same as the Linux commands, only we have some of the Hadoop commands is there. So you should know the Hadoop commands. I'm going to cover the Hadoop commands also. Okay. First is the Linux commands and Hadoop commands. And come to here. Here you are running the MapReduce program. Already I told you everything. What are the ecosystems you are running here? So everything, the backend is the MapReduce program only. But you are running the select star from table. Just you can assume that is the internal is converting in the MapReduce program. Is going to converting this some classes and retrieving the data. Means however, is converting into the Java code only. I will show you. If you want, I will show you the Java code how it is converted. So we have some tools is there. So it's automatically is converting into the MapReduce program and giving the result. But if you are converting, but in the back, in the front end, you are running the just SQL queries, HQL queries, but backend is converting into the MapReduce program. It's following the some framework, right? MapReduce framework. So that's why I'm going to cover the MapReduce framework also. Means MapReduce concepts. This is the totally theoretical. This is the some programming is there, some commands is there. Come to the MapReduce concepts or Hadoop command, Hadoop concepts. You can call it as a MapReduce concepts or Hadoop concepts. So this is the theoretical part. This is the theoretical part. I'm going to cover. This will help in the future also. This will help in the future. Any ecosystem will come. It should be depends on this MapReduce framework. So that's why I'm going to cover these concepts. Okay. How it is running, which component is helping to process the data, how the data is fetching, how the data is inserting, how the data is writing. So how the cluster is working, everything we will discuss. Okay, going forward, we'll discuss. So that's why I'm going to cover this Hadoop concepts and the MapReduce concepts as well. And fourth, I'm going to cover the one of the ecosystem is the Scoop. I'm going to cover the Scoop also. And fifth, I'm going to cover, I'm going to explain the what is the Spark. This is the latest ecosystem, right? This is the latest ecosystem. So that's why I'm going to cover this part. But if you want to work on a Spark, means you should have at least one language, right? So that's why I'm going to cover the basic scalar language also. And already you can able to write the scalar with the Spark. That is, we can call it as a Spark shell. I'm going to explain whenever we will discuss the Spark. I will explain how the prompt we can call it as an A. Okay, you can work on as a Python with the Spark. That is, we can call it as a PySpark. So I'm going to explain, if you have the scalar and Spark code is there, how we are going to converting into the PySpark code. I'm going to give one session. Okay, I'm going to explain one session in the how if we have the Spark and Scala code is there. Okay, already as part of our course, I'm going to explaining. Already you can able to write the Spark and Scala code. So how we are going to converting into the Python code? I'm going to explain that part also. Basic Python code, not the basic Python code. These are conversion of the Scala to Python. How we are going to converting? So I will explain that part. Okay, and come to the seventh is the project explanation. Yeah, it is the resume preparation. I will help to. So you are working with a different experience, right? So if you want the how to prepare the resumes, just you can connect with me. I will give some suggestions. And before that, I will share you that sample resumes also. So how to first of all, you have the 4 years of experience, 5 years of experience. How to prepare this big data resumes? I will give some sample resumes also. Okay. So as part of our course, I am going to cover these parts. So if you can know these things, you can able to work on any one of the ecosystem in future. Any one of the ecosystems is just you should explore that. You should explore that. First of all, here is the MongoDB is there. MongoDB is there. So how you are going to store the data? See, what is this? This is all the RDBMS, right? So I want to store the data is the MongoDB. So how you are going to store? So if you can know this part, only the thing is you should know how to connect to the MongoDB. That's it. You should know how to connect to this Cassandra. You should know how to connect to the HBase. Then remaining is the same only. We should explore that. If I am trying to explain all the ecosystem, it will take around the 1 year to 1.5 year time. If I want to try to explain all the ecosystems, this is the different one. Spark streaming and the Kafka streaming and the Flume is the different one. Only the 5 to 10% of the profiles is on the Kafka streaming and the Spark. If you have strong knowledge in the Java, then you can able to work on the Spark streaming and the Kafka streaming also. If you don't have not zero knowledge on the SQL queries and the any programming language, you can able to work as a big data developer. I will explain. I will give some what is required for that. I will provide all the thing, all the what is that? All the documents, all the concept I am going to cover. Don't worry about this. I don't know the Java. I don't know Scala. I don't know SQL queries. Don't bother about that. If you have the zero knowledge also, you can able to work as a big data developer. I will give that stuff. Okay. But if you want to work as the Spark streaming and the Kafka stream, this is very difficult. I'm frankly speaking. Difficult means if you can have strong knowledge in the Java, then you can able to write the code. If you want, I will show you the code also. This is very difficult. Okay. Come to the MapReduce program is also very difficult because of this is the purely depends on the Java code only. Most of the companies already is the banking domain. If you can take the insurance domains, still they are using the MapReduce program, but they are not developing. Just they are using for to enhancing purpose. And also some companies, they are migrating from the MapReduce to Spark only. Migrating the all the project. Yes, you can heard about this migration project, right? Why they are migrating? This is very difficult, right? In future, we are not going to maintain this MapReduce program. Means if you want to maintain this, means it is very difficult to write. If you want to enhance, if you want to update some code, it is very difficult because of just I will show you that one word count problem. If you want to solve that word count problem, you should have write in the 100 lines of the code. Just you can assume that only word count problem is there. If you want to solve that problem, you should write the 100 lines of the code in Java. Same code if you want to write in the Spark. Just 4 lines of the code. Just you can assume that. If you want to compile, if you want to update the code, if you want to change the code, compared to the 100 lines, compared to the 4 lines, what is that? It is very easy, right? If you want to compile, if you want to update. So that's why industry is looking for the Spark developers only. All the projects is in the previous, is a 10 years projects is there, right? They are in the MapReduce program. They are migrating from MapReduce to Spark only, Spark with Scala, Spark with Python. Okay, just it is very easy. Spark with Java also compared to the MapReduce program. But most of the companies, you can communicate with your who are working on the big data. Most of the companies using the Spark with Scala only. Next priority is the Spark with Python. Last priority is for the Spark with Java. Okay. Any questions, any doubts, please?